Hi guys, Robert Rivera here with the Rivera Trading Group and the Trader's Edge Forex Scalping System. And this is going to be a short video on the magic keys. I'm not going to share about installation because there are installation videos already in place. I'm just going to talk about how to program the magic keys to yourself and what are the most common buttons that are used. And this is because, again, you can customize the magic keys pretty much in many different ways. And there are many buttons here that can be used according to the customs that you would like to see. However, the main thing is how to open a trade, how to maybe create pending orders and such and such. And so let's go straight into it. First of all, to program it exactly how you want it, you want to double click over here. This is MetaTrader 5, right? This is MetaTrader 5. So you're going to see the little blue hat, like a cap from a graduation cap over here to the right. It's got to be blue. If you don't have the algo button on, then you can see how it's gray. So you got to turn it on to make sure it's blue. Also, when you first install it, you got to make sure that the common is algo trading allowed. And the dependencies is that allow DLL imports here also. Okay. Then here on the inputs, you're going to change this to whatever it is that you want it to be. It comes with automatically 2% risk. You can change that to 1%. Let's go ahead and make it 1%. Then let's say one of the other things that you might want to do is change the sound, because it comes already preset to make some loud sounds. If you're in the middle of the night, you want to keep your family from waking up from the alerts. You can change it here where it says true should play sound when empty. Let me go ahead and show you what it sounds like. Okay, so let's say you open cow. That's what it sounds like, and it assumes always a bullish position, right? So green is your take profit, red is your stop loss, and it's always going to calculate your position based on your stop loss. You can see the volume right now that you'll be assuming if you're taking a 1% risk. You can see this is a $5,000 demo, so a 1% risk, you can see the 1% risk right here, and it shows you the quantity that you would lose if it shows you the quantity that you would lose over here if it hits your stop loss, how much you will win if it hits your TP, your risk reward, and again the volume that will be taken. If you move this, then obviously it's going to recalculate everything based on the new risk reward, and if you move this, it also calculates then the risk, and the further you put it away, the lower the lot size is, the closer obviously that you are to your entry, the bigger the lot size is. All right. So having already determined the sound, which is what I was talking about, that sound, if you want to avoid that, you just simply go down here to where it says should play sound and just double click, make it false, boom. And now when you press the button, there is no sound. Okay. Which again is preferable if you are doing London and you're trying to keep your family from waking up. Another one of the buttons that I like to customize is a percentage of position close on the close custom button. Okay, that one is by default 25%. I like to do that 80 or 90. Let's go ahead and put an 80 in there. All right, now we have that set. What other things? You could change the colors. Also, because this is gold and not Forex pip, you want to make sure that the pip counter is set correctly, and this is now set correctly. By default is 1.0, but I had already changed it, so let's go show you what that looks like. So for example, if I was to enter, let's say a sell now, let's try to enter a sell now. Okay, so you hit open cow. Okay, I'm gonna put the red, this is a stop, right, above the green below, let's say around here, and let's enter a position by clicking open trade. Okay, boom, and there it is. All right, and because I changed the way that it reads the pip count, now this is accurate in pips, right? This is not points, this is pips. So the spread was already 2.5 or something like that, so basically you are break even right now. You can see the amount that is displayed down here. And since I'm already in a trade, I'm going to take advantage of it and start showing you how to mitigate losses. let's say, for example, well, it's already starting to move in our direction. Let's see. Okay. Let's say that you don't like the movement of price and you decided that you don't want to keep the all the risks that you have involved right now. Remember, we started with 1% risk because I changed it to 1% risk. So I'm going to click close half. And when I click close half, you're going to see the volume over here change from 25, probably to 12 or something. Okay, I'm going to click it now, close half. Boom, and there it is, 12 now, okay? Now you took half of your position off the market, and now you are content with the position that you have. Let's say that price went up, it comes down, it's looking like it's gonna go in your direction, you wanna add the position that you had before, you can go ahead and click double the trade, you press that button, double trade, boom, and now you have two positions. It shows you the total profit or loss over here. Yeah, it looks like it went in our direction. Yay, okay. So let's say, let's go ahead and do the scale fix again so we can better see the third line. Let me see if I can see it. Okay, so that's the first line, this is the second line, and this is the average line. In other words, if price comes back and it's right there and you close it, then you're gonna close at break even, all right? So now you've noticed again how just by simply pressing a button, you could cut it in half. By simply pressing another button, you can add your position back in. Let's say you like the profit that you are doing right now. You can either close a position here or just simply, let's see, do I have both the stop losses? There's another stop loss. Okay, down goes the stop losses up there. I can simply, let's say I like my profit I'm making right now. I'm going to go ahead and close half of that, okay, in profit. I just did, and now you can see the numbers change here again. And now I'm going to move my stop losses to break even so as to avoid, you know, I'm up 10 pips almost. So I'm gonna keep from this from taking me out, let's say, so, or send make it a loser after being a winner. So I'm gonna click stop loss at entry, which is one of the yellow buttons. Boom, and both stop losses go to the entry of their positions. All right, it's a beautiful thing, it's a beautiful thing. Okay, let's say that you like the way the price is moving and you think that it's going to crush even further. You think it's gonna go all the way down to here, okay? So you wanna set a pending order, let's say, once it breaks below this candle right here. I would probably put it around this candle right over here, but let's just do that, let's use that one, okay? So you would click open cal, okay, which is what you see there. And you would click mark pending. Okay, there it is. And then you can move the, you would move the, this is the profit. So let's keep moving the profit down. The stop loss goes above, let's say it's there. And this yellow line is the one that's going to put you in the trade, okay? So you're gonna put that line right there. This is now a sell stop. When it reaches here, it's gonna enter you. This is profit, this is stop loss, and just simply click open trade. There you go. And there's your pending order, okay? Now nothing is gonna happen. You're not gonna get triggered in until price reaches it. And once it reaches it, then you're going to be automatically put in the trade. Let's try a sell limit. Let's try a sell limit. Let's say that when it comes back up here, you want it to sell again. So you're gonna open cal, okay? You're gonna click mark pending. There's the pending, okay? We're gonna move that pending order to where you want it to go, right there. The take profit is gonna be down here. Stop loss, let's say it's over here, and now you have a sell limit in place. Okay, it tells you what the spread is going to be, what the spread is at the moment, then it tells you the risk that you're taking. Also over here on the left, you can't read it right now, but it tells you how much you're risking of your account and what are the chances that you may lose, how much you may lose in the trade. Hey, we're really winning this trade. This is good. Okay, and again, I think the only way to eliminate this is to go ahead and close it down here. Oh, by the way, I haven't even opened it. I just set it up. Now let's go ahead and open trade. Boom, and there it is. Now you have a limit order at the top, waiting for price to come back to sell to the bottom. It all has to do with how the green and, go ahead and close that, how the green, and let's go ahead and take profit, or should we, let me see, there's something else I can show you here on take profit. I think you can click also auto break even, but we're already at break even. Let's say, oh, it took us out. All right. That was a good trade though. Now let's say that you're convinced this is going to continue going down, right? And you want to, this is where you would set again your sell stop. Let's go ahead and sell a sell stop. Okay, we're going to click open cal. We're going to move the stop loss to over here. We're going to lose the take profit to, let's say, down here. And you're going to move this to about right there. And you're going to click open trade. Okay, now when it crosses that line, it will set you in the trade again. Let's see if it does it right here real quick. Also be aware that when you use the magic keys, it will enter you in the trade according to the risk parameters that you have set, 1% or 2% or whatever you has customized it to. In other words, it will not do it by the number up here. It won't do it by the number up here to the top left. It will go by the number that is already calculated. Now you can always enter a trade from up here. Let's say we enter a sell right now. Okay, you can always enter. I just showed you, I entered the trade. You can grab that and put, let's say you're gonna grab it and move it to take profit. You're gonna grab it and move it to stop loss. Okay, and now you can still manage the position with your magic keys. Okay, you can still cut it in half. You can still add to the position. And so that's another reason why I like the magic keys. I have the option of entering with the risk associated with the magic keys already as it is, or I can use the input buttons on the top left to enter a trade if I must do it quickly, okay? And I can still manage it with the magic key. The only problem is that you have to then know how to calculate your stop loss and your risk on the fly, you know? So let's go ahead and close this trade because it's not serving our purposes, and we'll close it, okay? And now we still have that pending order. Let's see if we get triggered into it. The problem that we have here is just, it's not a time for trading. Almost 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Let's see what else can we trade that may move a little faster. This time in the afternoon, the NASDAQ should be moving pretty heavy. Let's go to NASDAQ. Okay, there you go. All right, let's do a quick analysis. Ooh, very bullish. Very bullish, it can still move up. Looks like it still wants to move up. Dangerous to take a trade obviously right now, but okay, lower time frames are showing us kind of rejections. Let's see. Okay, all right, let's go ahead and enter a sell here. All right, so now let's go ahead, it's moving up by the moment, but I think it's rejecting up here. Let's go ahead and open cal. There it is. We're going to move the stop loss to the top. We're going to take profit somewhere down here, let's say, and we're going to press open trade. I'm just trying to get some activity going here so we can do some explanation as to what's going on. All right, so just watching the price movement at the moment. Okay, it's already knows what, I guess this is a 2% risk right here. Okay, let's go ahead and do the properties, scale fix, so I can better take a look at this as to what's going on. There you go. All right, looks like we're coming into profit. Let's see if it actually does reject. Okay. All right, so let's go ahead and do a pending order. Let's do a pending order because we were talking about that earlier, okay? Let's go ahead and do open cal, mark pending, and we want to put a stop loss up here. We're going to put the entry right there. We're going to take the profit, let's say somewhere down here. And let's see if we get triggered into click open trade. And now there's your pending order. Let's see if we get triggered into that pending order before the market closes, because it's closing here in the next 15 minutes. So some volatility is happening here. We're going to either lose really bad here or we're going to win really good. So let's see. Let's see if we can get that pending order to trigger. But let's go ahead and take partial profits on our volume that we have currently going. Okay. There you go. You see half of it is already taken out. I can move that stop loss to break even now if I wanted to make sure that I don't lose anything. There it is. Stop loss to break even. And if it breaks the low, then I'm going to get triggered into another position. Let's see if it does it. There you go. I got triggered into the other position. Let's see now. If it can continue going down. So now you saw how that pending order worked. And the beautiful thing about it is that, again, it calculates the risk for you. So it's based on the 2%, which is what it's programmed to do at the moment, okay? Every time that you open a new window for a new pair, you have to set the custom settings for that pair. Because it comes with its own custom settings. It's 2% and you get the sound like you're hearing it now and everything else. But if you want to customize that so that you don't get the sound, so that it calculates the numbers according to your preference, right? If you don't want to see all those numbers and you want to have a better idea of what this looks like in pips, you can change the decimal point where I showed you earlier and all that jazz. Yep, price is failing to continue. I'm going to let it run for you for a little bit. But bottom line is you saw what I wanted you to see, which is you set the limit order. You set the limit order. In this case, it was a sell stop. And it triggered you in when it crossed, and it triggered you in based on your parameters, based on your risk, okay? Now, and it already has your stop loss, it already has your take profit, okay? And you could have set that up and gone to work. You could have set that up and gone to cook. You could have set that up and go take a nap. And it will, you know that you're not risking beyond what you told it that you were willing to risk. So you're never going to be hurting your account if you're risk managing correctly. In just a moment, it's going to do something violent here, either to the upside or to the downside, because again, we're closing. There you go. There you go. There you go. Okay. Let's say you want to secure more of that. All right. Close half. Okay. Stop loss to break even. And now nothing can happen. You cannot lose this trade. Right? You cannot lose this trade now, no matter what happens. You can see the accumulated positions happening down here, how much you're winning on the one position, how much you're winning on the other. Let's say you want to close one of the positions. You can either close it here, I guess, or highlight it. Oh, there you go. Look at that. We got paid. We got paid. I told you that was happening. it's the close. Let's go ahead and make this. Let's hit our TP. Or let's take some more of it off. Okay, more of it off. Let's move a stop loss into profit. Let's move it there. And now we cannot lose that trade at all. It's all going to be money, even if it takes us out where it's at. Okay. That's about 20 pips. You know, that's what that looks like. Again, because of the decimal number is not in the correct place. I'm going to go ahead and close it because I want to capture this profit and I want to then show you something else. Okay. Let's go ahead and close by clicking on close full. There it is. Okay. Now, if you were to click open cal, it's going to show you over here what just happened today. Okay. I have four wins. This is what we did over here. This while we were doing this. Okay. Four wins, one loss. What was the gain? $152, which is a 2.88%. Amazing. In what? About 10 minutes, we did 2.88%, almost 3% for the day. Pretty good day. Okay. I love the fact that it has this here. Let's go pick this position just so that I can show you. Okay. So now we're going to try to move the auto to break even. Okay. So let's say once price gets, no, that's not it. That's not the entry. This right here. Once price hits this, it's going to move the stop loss to break even. All right. So to make the break even button, you need to press the auto break even. It's a green button. And then you hit enter. Okay, we're going to see the stop loss move from up here to break even once it gets to it. Let's see if it can get to it. See if we can get that price to hit it. This is the close of the market. For a few minutes now, it's still going to be doing orders. So hopefully it can get there. Okay, so we know what's going to happen when price hits the purple line, which is it's going to break even, right? It's going to move the stop loss to break even, which is the entry green line right here. Let's go ahead and open one for partial TP. So this is going to be our partial TP. Oh, shoot. There we go again. This is going to be our partial TP. Okay. You got to tell it how much is it that you want to take. Okay. 50%. Let's set it at 50% and then let's enter. Boom, and there you go. Now it's set in place. And now all we do is wait, right? We have the break-even number there, and we have a take partial profit over here. Let's see if I can make it there. The New York Stock Exchange has closed, so there's going to be very little volume now. Some point tonight, this would be resolved, but I wanted you to see how to use the most common buttons that we use with magic keys. I showed you how to use the open cal, which is what opens the market, right? When you do that, you can move the red line to your stop loss, your green line to your take profit if you were doing a bullish move. If you're doing a bearish move, then you'd move the profit to the bottom, the red to the top, and you got to remember to do that. You can also just simply click the switch button, but my switch button is not working because I think I changed something in the settings. But again, we discussed open cal, which is that, okay? If you are already in a trade and you want to double your position, such as right now, you can just simply click double trade. There it is. And now you have doubled the position that you had before, has now been doubled. Now that you press the double trade, you have two trades going on of the same previous price that you had before. We discussed also close half. Let's go ahead and close half. Well, we can't close half anymore because that's the lowest volume. We discussed close half, we discussed close full, we discussed close custom. Even though I didn't ever at any given time press the close customs because that would have taken most of the position out and then I couldn't do the other transactions. We discussed auto break even, which you can see right here. You can see also the partial take profits right over here. And those are the most common ones that I use. And you can program the other buttons. Let's go ahead and close everything. You can also program the function one, function two, function three, function four numbers to however you want to use it. And also, again, by going back here, you can customize anything that you want. So right now, as you saw, before I did, I changed the risk number. Let's go ahead and change the risk here to 1%, just so you can see. Okay, I can change the sound like I did before. Change the sound here, default. Change the pip counter over here to more adequately reflect whether this is gold or whether it is in an index. You would want to change those decimal numbers so that it reflects accurately what it is that you're looking at. And the percentage wise, right, where is it? Right here, double custom. Let's say that 80%. And now you want to save this. You click save and you click it. You create it as default. You want to replace the default? Yes. Okay. And now, okay. And now anytime that you open the magic keys, that is going to be your default setting. One of the best features of this is that you can keep track of what's going on with your trades. Click on open cal and you can see again what you did today, how your trades went today. And yeah, you can also program this so that when you reach a certain number of trades, it automatically shuts down and doesn't let you enter any more trades. You can do that also. There are plenty of videos of all that. I just want to show you the most common buttons that I use and how you can benefit from magic keys. Again, I have a discount code for you guys. I have affiliate number if you want it. You get a 10% discount for these, okay? That's it for today. God bless you guys. Bye-bye.